So to start off my at-home facial, I'm going to get my skin extra squeaky clean using my Beauticontrol facial wash, which you guys know I love, paired with my Clarisonic Mia. The reason I'm doing this is because I want to remove any dirt or grime off of my face because I do not want anything on my face when I'm doing my microdermabrasion treatment. So if you don't have a brush, you can feel free to use a washcloth or a handheld brush that's $2 to $3 that they sell at Sally's Beauty Supply. So the important part when you're doing a microdermabrasion treatment is to let your skin dry for 5 minutes. You want it completely dry. I have the Mary Kay Time-Wise Microdermabrasion, which can be used wet and is a fast alternative, but today we're using the PMD, and I absolutely love this because it has aluminum oxide microcrystals on the disc that gently sweep away dead skin. So as you can see, this has a power button and it does need to be plugged into the wall. It also comes with different size suction caps, along with different discs, a white for practice, a blue for gentle exfoliation, and a green that's a little bit of a deeper exfoliation. They also have a red, which is a way more aggressive exfoliation, which is recommended if you're using this for quite some time. So we're speeding things up so you guys can see what I'm doing, and you can see that the dead skin is definitely being pushed off of my face. Now this is supposed to suck the dead skin up, but it doesn't necessarily suck everything up because you do see the residue on my face, but it's great because you guys can actually see that this works. You want to make sure to keep your skin nice and taut, which is why you can see I've been pulling my face side to side, my chin up, because if you let your skin stay loose, it can tug and it can damage your skin. I will warn you guys that your skin can be red for about 24 hours afterwards, but that is normal. So I definitely would recommend doing this on a day off when you don't have to wear makeup. So you can see that there's a lot of dead skin cells on my face that are just disgusting, so you want to wipe that off with a damp cloth, or you can rinse it off in the sink. So I'm following up with a warming trend green tea mask that I love from Beauticontrol. It's warming, it soothes the skin, it didn't tingle or burn my skin after that treatment either, so I really enjoyed it. And you don't have to let this dry, you just rub it in for 2 minutes and it's nice and warm, and then you can rinse off. So the suction from the PMD motivates collagen production, and as you can see, I'm already getting a really nice glow from my treatment. I forgot to show you guys my toner, but you can follow up with any toner of your choice just to kind of replenish the balance of your skin. I'm following up with Time-Wise Night Solution by Mary Kay, which has a lot of vitamins and minerals that are just going to restore my skin as well after that treatment. I recommend doing the microdermabrasion maybe once a week at the most. You don't want to use it any more than that because your skin can become raw. So now I'm going to follow up with my MAC Fast Response Eye Cream, which I love, just to give my face a little more moisture because I absolutely love this stuff. It just melts into your skin. And then the last step is moisturizing, and I have a microdermabrasion Time-Wise lotion from Mary Kay, which I love because it just is very light. It doesn't create a lot of grease or heavy weight, and it really replenishes your skin after exfoliating. So we can't forget our pretty little smackers, and I'm using my Mary Kay Satin Lips Lip Balm. I love this stuff because it makes your lips hydrated immediately. So as you can see, my face has a really nice glow already. It feels really soft and smooth, and I'm really happy with the PMD and the way my at-home facial turned out. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and thank you so much for watching, and all links will be down below. I love you guys. Bye!